Hi, I'm Nancy DeVue, and I'm excited to talk about Agile and continuous threat modeling. It's a new way to threat model. In order for everyone to perform an Agile and continuous threat model, we need to make sure everyone embraces the Agile and continuous methodology. It is critical to think about how we apply security and our ever-increasingly faster cycles for development, operations, and hacking, almost seemingly to move at the speed of light. The core principles of the Agile methodology manifesto include valuing individuals and interactions over processes and tools, valuing working software, products, and systems over comprehensive documentation. So you can already see where we're starting to go with these threat models, right? Let me repeat these first 2 points. Valuing individuals and interactions over processes and tools. Valuing working software, products, and systems over comprehensive documentation. The manifesto also includes valuing collaboration over enforcement of security, valuing response to change over following a plan, and now combine that with continuous methodology principles that include continuous ideation instead of once and done, continuous integration, development, and deployment instead of operating on systems that were designed years ago, continuous team evolution, so team members can come and go without impact to your products and services, continuous security evolution to stay on top of current security vulnerabilities, attacks, and attack surfaces. Our Agile and Continuous Threat Modeling workshop is just 1 day long. We bring the entire DevSecOps team into a room for a whole day. The engineers, the architects, the developers, the testers, the operations, and the administrators. Just think about how the perspectives of each person is going to have an impact on thinking about how the real-world security is required to protect their customers, their product, and their business. In the workshop, we have 4 steps. The first 2 steps take about 1.5 to 2 hours. We introduce the topic of security, talk about background goals, and go through some exercises. And it's important to do this because not everyone is a security expert. As a part of these discussions, we talk about how to perform an agile and continuous threat model. I'm going to give you a couple examples of the exercises in the full presentation. So come attend the RSA conference Thursday, April 19th at 9:15 a.m. for the full version of the Agile and Continuous Threat Modeling session. It's listed as session code DEV-R04. The third step is to perform a live threat model on the product, tool, application, or service that team is responsible for. And the 4th step during the workshop is we spend the last part of the day reviewing with that team the findings to assign a risk ranking and owners for all the action items. With Agile and continuous threat modeling, it is the responsibility of every person to build security in. We are changing the culture. It is not the responsibility of some external security architect to force people to perform the right security best practices. Again, it's the responsibility of every person to build security in. Come hear more about this exciting new way to threat model at the RSA conference Thursday, April 19th at 9:15 a.m., session code DEV-R04 for the full version of the Agile and Continuous Threat Modeling session. Hope to see you there. Thank you.